Absolutely love that music. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'm binge watching season 2 of Stranger Things. So far, so good. It's right on par with season 1. I cannot choose which one I like better. I think they're dead even. A few people told me this one was a lot scarier. At the moment, it's definitely not scarier whatsoever. It is a lot more mysterious. I do have a lot more questions with this one. It definitely doesn't seem as predictable, so I'm really looking forward to finishing off the entire season. I've watched the first 5 episodes, and I've just taken a break just to make a quick video and let you guys and gals know what I think so far, 5 episodes in, so just over halfway. And we are introduced to some new characters as well, which is quite refreshing. We're introduced to Max, or aka Mad Max, who's a female character in this, and actually makes friends with the boys and starts adventuring out with them. Seems like she's actually a nice little fit. Instead of all males, we've got a female in there as well. Now, Billy is probably my favorite new character. He is the badass that drives a muscle car to high school, smoking and blasting away heavy metal music. Pretty much the guy that I wanted to be if I was able to drive a car, you know, in my high school days. Unfortunately, in Australia, we had to wait till we were 18 to drive a car, and I was already out of high school. Damn you Americans, you get everything. But you can drink till 21, so, huh. Sean Astin is also in this. For those of you that don't know who Sean Astin is, he was Sam Frodo's right-hand man in Lord of the Rings. He was also the leader of the Goonies in that movie. You have to have all seen the Goonies, otherwise you probably wouldn't be watching Stranger Things. It's very reminiscent of the Goonies. I always compare it to the Goonies and Stand By Me. Ultra nostalgic, just like those films, particularly for us that have seen them and grew up with those kinds of films. And if not, hopefully you're showing your children those films, because they're awesome films that you can watch together with your families. Anyway, back to Stranger Things 2. Sean Astin plays Bob Newby, who's actually Joyce Byers' love interest. And I've actually identified what I think is a clever little reference in the film to something else that he's done in the past. Now, Sean Astin was in a movie in 1991 called Toy Soldiers, basically about an ultra-rich boarding school for boys that gets taken over by terrorists. And Sean Astin plays the lead character, Billy, who has a group of teenage friends who band together and try and, you know, beat the terrorists and get information out to the outside, to the FBI, so they can take control of the situation. Now, at the beginning of this movie, Billy takes his friends down to the basement in this boarding school, and he has some sort of equipment that allows him to hack into the phone line. So he finds a phone line in the basement, and what he does with his friends, he hacks into the phone line, and they call a sex line, you know, having a bit of fun late at night, teenage boys, what else are you going to do? While drinking vodka. Now, the headmaster is up in his office and notices a phone line flashing, and he activates the line and he can hear all this sex talk going on. So he goes down to the basement, busts Billy doing what he's doing, and asks him, "Where did you get this equipment from?" And Billy answers, "Radio Shack."
"Yes. You know, this is really, really ingenious."
"No, nothing. Used to hook the little..."
"Where'd you get this stuff?"
"Radio Shack."
"Really?"
"Mm-hmm."
"Was it expensive?"
No, I picked it up on sale."
Now, funnily enough, in episode 3, I believe it was, Bob Newby reveals that he has a job at Radio Shack.
"Radio Shack.
Bob Newby speaking. How can I help you?"
So I don't know if this is just absolute coincidence. I don't think it's a coincidence. I think it's a clever little reference to Sean Astin's character in that movie, Toy Soldiers. Let me know if you identified that, and also let me know if you think I'm right, or if it's just coincidence. But so far, the same nostalgia is there as season 1. Reminds me a lot of movies that I've seen growing up. The soundtrack is top notch once again. The cool little references to things that were occurring around 1984, I was ultra impressed with as well, such as Terminator first coming out to the cinema. Now, I do want to point out that there is closure on the fate of 11. We definitely find out what happens with 11. So if you're all wondering, you know, oh, what happens with her, don't worry, because in the first episode, you find out the fate of 11 and it's all revealed. The story goes on. So far, there's no Demogorgon. There is what seems like a new enemy in this, but it's not actually confirmed just yet. That's what I mean. It's really ultra mysterious at the moment. I'm not too sure what's going to happen, but we do know that Will has a huge role to play in this. The kid that disappeared originally in season one, who's back, he has all these little flashbacks. Well, not flashbacks. They're actually episodes of entering the upside down world, this other dimension again, and it happens uncontrollably. So he's not too sure whether it's real or whether it's just some sort of vision based on the traumatic past. I think we all know where it's going to go with that anyway. But I really think that the remaining four episodes is what's going to be like ultra important right now. I think the pieces are really going to come together. Jim Hopper, the policeman, has his hands ultra full. I can't exactly say what's going on with him without giving away spoilers, so that's all I will say. There's definitely stuff going on there, more than enough to keep everyone interested. If you liked season one, you're definitely going to love this as well. But all in all, so far, it's right on par there. It's definitely not worse. I can't say it's better, but season one was absolutely sensational. It kept me interested the whole time, and this one is doing the exact same thing. Whether or not that changes in the next four episodes, I don't know. I don't think so. I definitely don't think it'll go downhill. Maybe it'll get better when things ramp up and start getting pieced together a little bit. It just depends how the pieces are put together for me, because it can easily be ruined if they try and be either overly clever or just go down some sort of stupid, ridiculous path. So I'll definitely be back real soon and I'll give you a full review of the season and maybe we'll discuss some spoilers as well. You just let me know what you guys and gals want to see in the comments below. And as always, I appreciate y'all watching.